We are now in the final countdown. But toward what? Well, here to talk about the what of the final countdown is Pastor Billy Crone. Billy, it's really great to have you back again.
Gary, it's always great to be on. Thanks for having me.
You've written a book. You've produced 8 DVDs. In fact, 16 DVDs. And I'm holding the latest series right here, right now. We're going to be talking about it. What is it that we're counting down to that is something we all need to know about?
Well, I'll let Jesus, of course, define that for us. It's he says in Matthew 24, it is the worst time in the history of mankind, so horrible that unless God shortened the time frame, the entire human race will be destroyed. It's called the 7-year tribulation. That's what we're headed towards. And the final countdown is God's prophetic time clock is we're running out of time. Now, the good news is if you're a born-again Christian, we're not afraid of that. We know that God has rescued us. He's not appointed us. He has saved us from his wrath. And the 7-year tribulation is an outpouring of God's wrath on this planet for 7 years nonstop. That's why Jesus said it's the worst time in the history of mankind. I mean, back with the last judgment, with the Noah's flood on the earth, happened relatively quickly, if you will. Noah was in the ark for over a year. But this is something that's going to last for not 1 year, not 2 years, not 3 years, 7 years of God's wrath being poured out on this planet. And it's going to be the worst time. You don't want to be there. So as a Christian, I'm not afraid. But as a non-Christian, you better wake up.
Well, let me play the role of the scoffer for a minute here. We've heard about this for years,
yeah.
Decades. People have been saying, oh, Jesus is coming soon, you know. And look at this, and look at this, and look at these signs right here. And, oh, it's got to happen. And then it doesn't happen. And yeah. People say, I'm tired of this. I'm tired of just tuning my life into to some kind of expectation, and I'm always disappointed. I expected him to come like 20 years ago, and he didn't come. How do we deal with that? And I think all Christians who are expecting the return of Jesus, you know, get excited from time to time, and they say, oh, wow, I was wrong again.
Yeah.
How do we deal with this exactly? And I know that you deal with this question all the time.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, I think that's one of the benefits of a specific Bible study, and that's what this is all about, on modern technology. First of all, the scoffer, the person who actually is scoffing, little do they realize, Gary, they're fulfilling Bible prophecy, right? 2 Peter chapter 3, scoffers would come. And what do they say? The same old thing that we hear all the time as Christians. And where is his coming? Nothing's ever changed since the beginning, blah, blah, blah. Right. Same thing today. Not when you look at modern technology, because the technology that is needed to pull off the events in the 7-year tribulation, they are coming into play in our lifetime. And so you can't say it's the same old when it comes to that aspect. Just a couple recent events. I'm firmly convinced that the internet is something that is needed to pull off what is described in the 7-year tribulation. I'm convinced that the Big Brother technology for the Antichrist and the false prophet to micromanage the planet, that technology is here today. In fact, you want to talk about specifics, not just the birth of computer technology, the internet, Big Brother related issues, but something as recent that is even being rolled out right now, Gary, something called the 5G network, I believe has everything to do with the technology needed to pull off the events in the 7-year tribulation. The 5G network, of course, is the new upgrade system for people to access the internet. To give you an idea of how fast this thing is, 3G network, the old 3G system that we had, if you wanted to download a 2-hour movie, took you about 24, 26 hours. The 5G network, 3.6 seconds. And you think, okay, well, that's kind of cool. It's convenient. I can surf the web even faster and get information even faster. No, 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 you don't understand. What they want to do with this system, Gary, this 5G system, is they want to connect. It's called the Internet of Things, IoT, the Internet of Things, to create a matrix around the whole planet with this improved system, the 5G network, to be able to connect every single product, every single person that contains a microchip. that they can weave into this weaveless system to where they will be able to access anything that carries a microchip. I'm talking appliances, I'm talking vehicles, I'm talking your phones, I'm talking your computers, every product on the planet and every person. This system allows them to create that web. Now, why is that important? Because that's what the Bible says the Antichrist and the false prophet are going to do. They're going to control all the buying and selling. Stop right there. How are you going to control the buying and selling? You would have to have the ability to connect to every single product on the planet. Guess what? The 5G system allows them to do that. You wouldn't just have to connect the buying and the selling. It's not just the product. It's the other half of that equation, people buying and selling. So how are you going to connect and know the location of people on the planet at the same time with the buying and selling? The 5G network. Mm-hmm. Does the same thing. That system is being rolled out right now. You can't say it's the same old, nothing ever changes. That is happening in our lifetime. Now, again, these are events, I believe, that are going to culminate ultimately in the seven-year tribulation. So if you're not saved, you better get saved right now. Time is running out. If you are saved, I'm not afraid of the seven-year tribulation. I'm not going into it. But what it sends home for you and I as the Christian, stop procrastinating. Get busy living for Jesus and sharing Jesus with as many people as you can, because he is the only way out of this mess. He's the one that told us this is the worst time in the history of mankind. You don't want to be there. Praise God, Gary. He died on the cross, so we don't have to be.
And Billy, as you're talking, I'm thinking about sci-fi. Now, today's young generation just thrives on sci-fi, you know. The Avengers and Superman and Superwoman and there are a dozen superheroes out there, and they're using superpowers and super technology and fighting these incredible wars. And you know, every time I see a preview of one of those things, it looks to me like the Great Tribulation.
Yeah,
they're getting ready for the tribulation.
Yeah,
but you're getting ready for the tribulation by warning people that hey, it's here. Let's talk for a minute about Big Brother.
Yeah.
The old idea of Big Brother started way back in the 50s and 60s.
Yeah.
You know, Brave New World, Aldous Huxley, and he envisioned a world that was covered by spies. They were everywhere. They saw everything you did, and in certain cases, they even had cameras located downtown on television, on telephone poles,
yeah,
so that they could take pictures of you as you went about your daily work. Well, back in the 50s, they didn't have the high tech that we do now, but nevertheless, this guy envisioned what was to come,
and it
was a horror to him.
Yeah.
He presented it in his book as a horrible thing. I agree. Now we have technology. Let's talk for a minute about Chinese cities where you are followed virtually step by step in everything you ever do.
Yeah. You're right. The scenario with George Orwell, Gary, when you understand what's going on, not coming already here.
Yes.
Not only in China, but even here in the United States. It makes what George Orwell predicted look like chump change.
Yeah,
we're so far beyond that, it's not even funny. And most people don't even realize it. They've been warmed up to it. How much we are living, literally, like rats in a cage. We're being monitored on a massive scale. Let me just ramp it up for you. In the UK right now, cameras in the cities, private sector, everywhere, they have an estimated 6 million cameras. The average Briton today, right now, from the time they step out of the door and they get back home from work, are filmed on 300 different cameras. That's in the UK. It's called the surveillance canopy. You think that's bad, Gary? Here in the United States, that's 6 million cameras. We have 30 million cameras in the United States. It's not just Europe. It's our own country doing the same thing. You mentioned China.
Yeah.
China has 170 million cameras monitoring their people. And they said in the next couple years, they're going to add 400 million more to that.
So if they want to find you, they can find you.
There is no way of escape. A lot of people say, oh, I'm just going to somehow, I don't need Jesus. You Christians are a bunch of wackos. But just in case I'm wrong about the rapture and I see you disappear, I still don't need God. I'm just going to become the ultimate survivor. I'm just going to buy a piece of property and head out to the hills and I'll be safe. Ha ha, you ain't making it out your front door. You ain't going nowhere. They know everything about you. They not only see everything about you, they hear their monitor conversations. A lot of these camera systems, Gary, it isn't just videotaping. They have microphones. Microphones recording conversations, public access, private access. We even document, they're even putting microphones on street corner stuff. And I'm talking not just in China, I'm talking here in the United States. They are monitoring everything way beyond anything George Orwell predicted.
And the technology is amazing. In fact, the subtitle on Billy's book is Modern Technology. Well, you hear those terms, you think, I've heard about modern technology. No, you haven't. Yeah. Not if you haven't read this book.
Yeah.
Modern technology, you talked about microphones, yeah. that pick up somebody's voice, like wherever he might be going.
Yeah.
They have new kinds of microphones now that nobody ever dreamed of before.
Yeah.
That work by lasers.
Yeah.
And if they want to pick you up a mile away, they can.
Yeah. They can shoot a beam. We document this. And, you know, one thing about the elites, they'll let you know what they're doing if you're paying attention.
Yeah.
Most people, unfortunately, aren't. But so we even share, even news broadcasts, they admit that they could shoot a beam into your house.
Right.
And they could recreate the audio that you're speaking in your house, any conversation, even off a bag of chips. They can make the bag of chips vibrate, which will turn into a speaker, and they could record your conversations. Plants, even off of plant leaves, they can create. I'm not making this up. It sounds, you talk about science fiction. This is actual technology that they could do. There is no place to hide. We're already living in that system that I believe is going to culminate in the 7-year tribulation. But back to the China aspect, man, I really think that China certainly is the playground for the Antichrist system that's going to be fully implemented on a global basis.
Yes.
They are so far ahead of the curve. We're not far behind. I'll get to that in a second. But they not only know everything about their people in this huge, massive mega database of the characteristics, likes, and dislikes, but they're being so monitored, they've created a social credit system to where they don't know everything you do, but they will punish you when you don't do what you're supposed to do. And they will shut you out of the system. People right now in China, because they're not doing what they're told to do, they cannot fly. They can't open a bank account. They can't own real estate. And even something like this, they can't get high-speed internet. But they say if you do what you're told to do, they'll give you discounts. You'll get a great interest rate on a loan. And listen to this. They'll even bump up your social profile on your dating profile so you can get an extra super spouse or something. It's crazy. Gary, they're already implementing this system to where, listen, if you do what you're told, you'll be rewarded. If you don't do what you're told, and we'll know about it with this Big Brother technology, you will be punished and shut out of the system. Where am I going with that? Revelation 13. What does the Antichrist and the false prophet do? You better worship this guy, and if you don't, we're going to kill you, and then you better take this mark, and if you don't, we're going to shut you out of the system. It's already happening in China. Now, back to China. That's just their social credit score system. Oh, by the way, if you're paying attention to the media, you know what our secular media is actually starting to say? Could America be next? Because we're tied to the same database system and they're getting all this information on us. Maybe we're going to have an American social credit score system. But anyway, China is so far ahead on their surveillance canopy that they've built that they can find anybody they want anywhere on a massive scale. We actually share a video clip of a BBC reporter. It's just recently happened. He goes into one of the huge cities over there in China. And China, of course, has a database on the people, including their faces and whatever. And they're combining that with facial recognition software, AI technology.
Right.
And they could find anybody they want just like that, right? No matter where you go in the city. A BBC reporter went into there just to experiment how high-tech was their system. And he wasn't in their database system. So he landed at the airport in this huge city. And they basically said, okay, take off. And as soon as he took off, they went ahead and submitted to the authorities a picture of this guy's face. They put it into the Chinese system. And you know how long it took for them to not just find him, but the police literally rounded him up in this huge city. And he'd never been in the system before. And all they gave is submitted a picture of his face. 7 minutes, Gary. They found the guy in this huge city in 7 minutes with their current technology. And what's concerning is, you're thinking, well, man, I'm glad I don't live in China. Gary, there's something that we use all the time, that people use. It's not called leg book. It's not arm book. It's Facebook.
Facebook.
Facebook is not only a recent development, right, in our lifetime, so you can't say it's old, the same old, nothing ever changes. No, social media has everything to do with this Big Brother technology, because now it's coming out that Facebook is developing these huge dossiers on us. They know everything about us. They know all of our likes, our dislikes, our political persuasions, our religious persuasions, all of our contacts, the places we go, not only that, but it's called what? Facebook for a reason. And so we are freely giving these people what? Our faces. In fact, they're saying that the facial recognition software that Facebook uses, you can't deceive it. And we've even shared news clips and reports of people putting on disguises. Facebook knows it's you. You can't fool Facebook because we've given them so much of this. So would they think it's just in China? Yeah. It's already over here, folks.
And I'm sure you've studied this, but the reverse is also true. They can watch you and then create a synthetic you on a screen, and nobody will be able to tell that it's not you on the screen.
Gary, I'm so glad you brought that up, because that blew me away in the research when I came across this. For the 80s fans out there, they might remember this movie by Arnold Schwarzenegger called The Running Man. I don't necessarily recommend it. I think it's an R-rated movie. But basically, in order to go into this Running Man thing, Richard Dawson, the other evil character guy, they wanted him to be a part of this latest game where they basically, unfortunately, kill people, and it's not a good thing. But anyway, so they set him up. You know how they set him up? According to the movie premise. And they basically manipulated a video of Arnold, the character he was playing, to make him look like a bad guy, like he killed people and did stuff. And so basically created a public outcry. Go round him up. And it was an excuse to basically force him to go into the Running Man show, right?
Wow.
Here's what's wild. I didn't know this. That was made in the 80s. They actually, in that movie, it depicted a future, totalitarian, horrible society where they could even manipulate videos and make you say and things that you never did, but the public will never know. Do you know what year they depicted that movie? 2019.
Really?
Gary, it blew me away. I'm not making it up. Go check it out. It hit the nail on the head. And what's happening today? We bring out two recent technological developments. Number one, most people don't realize this. They have basically Photoshop audio that has now just come out. They can actually make you say things that you never said before with the click of a mouse. And we demonstrate that, show it on video. This is their own demonstration. One guy, they just took a snippet where he said, "I kiss my dogs and my wife three times." His actual voice. That was the legitimate recording. They basically just splice. And then they inserted words he never even said. But when they pushed playback, it was his actual voice. His actual tone. It was crazy. It's a Photoshop for voice. Photoshop voiceovers. And so then all of a sudden they changed it and it says, "I kiss Jordan," another lady, you know, three times. It just completely manipulated the words. Now, combine that with the other thing that's now in the news, even our own government starting to get concerned about this, but this is the modern technology that's in place. They're called deep fake videos. And deep fake videos is you not only can make people say things, just like the Running Man premise, that they never said, but you never know it's their actual voice, but their faces move perfectly with it.
I have to interrupt you because I'm looking at my Bible as you're talking. Revelation 13, they worship the dragon which gave power unto the beast, and they worship the beast saying, "Who's like unto the beast? Who's able to make war with him?" And this is the part that really rang a bell. "And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things."
Yeah.
Now, how do you suppose he has a mouth speaking great things? Through the technology you're talking about.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like to me.
Oh, absolutely. Well, and it says there, "And he was given authority over every tribe, people, not only nation, but language." And Gary, that's another thing that's happening with modern technology. Basically, you saw mankind right after the last judgment with the worldwide flood. Shortly after that, unfortunately, rebelled again against God. Do you think a flood would get their attention? And that's the Tower of Babel. Now, what happened? Mankind was of one language at that time. They rebelled against God, began to build this tower. So what did God do? He confused the languages. And that's where we get all the different languages in the world today. There's about 6,500 different languages in the world right now. Well, the Bible says the planet, once again, is going to rebel against God under this Antichrist and false prophet regime, right? Well, if you're going to unify the planet, then you need to do something about the language barrier. Gary, the language barrier is gone, and we demonstrate that. And this has been going on for a while. Back in 1959, IBM created what was called an automatic language translator for the military. Then with the birth of the internet, we had services like Babelfish. I used to use this back in the early 2000s. We get emails from people around the world. I don't speak Italian, whatever. Right. And so I would literally cut and paste put it into Babelfish, say I want it in English, hit a button, and it automatically translated for me. And that seemed like huge. That's nothing. Listen to this. Google just came out with what's called Google Pixel Buds, and we shared their demonstration. And so the guy, there's a lady from Sweden across from him, and she's wearing her Google Pixel Buds, and he's wearing his. So he speaks to her in English. The Pixel Buds automatically translate it into Swedish. She hears it in her language in real time. She speaks back to him in Swedish, and then instantly it's translated into English. And so they're in real time communicating back and forth. Modern technology has brought down the language barrier. Just in time for, unfortunately, another rebellion against God, just like the Tower of Babel, it's been reversed. And I don't think it's by chance. You mentioned his mouth.
Yes.
It says there he had authority over what? Not just people, not just tribe, not just nations, but languages. Right. He's got authority over languages. The language barrier has come down. Now you can fool the planet into joining your rebellion against God.
You know, I'm thinking, we used to watch Star Trek, Captain Kirk and Spock and the others, and they would beam down to a planet.
Yeah.
And they will always be able to talk to the natives.
Yeah.
And vice versa.
Yeah.
And everybody said, how can they do that? How can they do? And he said, well, see that little emblem that he's wearing on his shirt?
Yeah.
That's an instantaneous translator. Oh, well, that takes care of the whole problem.
Yeah.
In other words, people were thinking about this sort of thing decades ago.
Yeah.
They just didn't have the technology, but now they do.
That's the point. It's here now. It's not coming. It's here now. And again, that dispels the scoffer. Oh, it's the same. You guys keep... No. Not when you understand modern technology. Now, let me add one more aspect of modern technology to that language barrier coming down. Another aspect we know about the Antichrist is it talks about this image that can speak and to cause all who refuse to die, right?
Right.
So there's this image aspect. So we got the mouth, you got the language, but there's this image. Kid you not, Gary, we shared the actual video clip. This actually happened where I live in Vegas, right? Azure Marketing Technology. They have created, they could take any person making a presentation, and they create a life-size 3D hologram, full-color 3D hologram of the person giving the presentation. Mm-hmm. Not only that, their technology combines it with AI so that as when they speak, they say, okay, I don't know a stitch of Japanese, but I'm going to be giving this presentation to the Japanese. First of all, you can not only beam that image across the planet, but they demonstrated it, pushed the button. This lady had a perfect 3D hologram of herself speaking her presentation in perfect Japanese with her own voice inflections. All generated by AI, all here right now. So now you go back to the Antichrist. How is this guy going to make an announcement? There's 6,500 different languages around the world. He hits a button. Here goes this image, and it speaks instantly all different languages. Gary, that technology is here now.
And I'm looking at my King James Bible. A mouth speaking great things and the image of the beast.
Yeah.
There it is.
Right. And so what's the point? Man, okay, if that's the events that happen in the seven-year tribulation, and we see the technology for the first time in the history of mankind here now, not coming, then logically, how much closer is the rapture of the church, which happens prior? So if I'm a Christian, get busy living for the Lord. Get busy sharing the gospel. If I'm not a Christian, man, there is only one way out of this mess. And
you
it's not a bug-out shelter, it's Jesus Christ.
We talked about this before we came on today, and people can get tired of being told that the rapture is right around the corner. You know, after a few years, you say, oh, you know, I'm not even going to look anymore.
Yeah.
But we are seeing things unfold at breakneck speed.
Yeah.
It can't be much longer.
No.
And I am walking by faith in the soon coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if he doesn't come during my life, fine. I'm not disappointed, because the blessed hope lends a kind of quality to your life that is just absent if you're not expecting the Lord to return at any moment.
Well, again, there's a blessedness to it in that I guarantee you, if you really live within the reality, which is a biblical reality, by the way,
right,
that the rapture is imminent, then you know what you're not going to do? You're not going to procrastinate, are you? Number one, sharing the gospel.
Right.
Number two, you're not going to have a tendency to goof off and be a bad witness to the people around you. And number three, I say this all the time. Did you realize, Gary, that as a Christian, when the rapture happens, Jesus is going to find you doing something? Let that one sink in for a little bit. And so, Christian, ask yourself, if the rapture were to happen today, and it could,
right,
then what is your pattern of life right now? Not what you hope to do, or is it stories of, man, I used to be on fire for Jesus, I used to share the gospel, but yeah, lately I just really... Is that the state you want him to find you in? Because he's going to find you doing something.
Yep, that's right.
But when you really live within the reality of the biblical truth of the imminency of the rapture, man, it shores up those loose ends, and hopefully and prayerfully he'll find you. You know, and I've always often said this, wouldn't it be cool, Gary, if the last thing we were doing as Christians and the rapture happened is we had just got done witnessing to somebody. Maybe he was the last Gentile, right? And we were holding hands and we're praying together and they're receiving Christ their Savior, and both of us at the same time say, amen, and boom, the rapture happens. Now, wouldn't that be the way to go?
It would be.
Well, Gary, guess what? It's going to happen one day, and it could happen today. And Christian, don't fool yourself if you think that he's not going to find you doing what? If you realize time is running out, modern technology drills that into your head. It's a wake-up call.
Well, the Bible talks about equipping the saints, and that's what you're doing, Billy. You're giving the saints a little information here, and again, the key words concerning this book are two in number. Modern technology. You want to find out about it, how it's going to affect your, in fact, it is affecting your life even as we speak. Modern technology, the final countdown, Tribulation Rising, Volume 2, yours for $25. If you go to the online bookstore, prophecywatchers.tv, scroll down, you'll find Billy's name, and you'll find the final countdown, Tribulation Rising, Part 2, or Volume 2. By the way, yours for $25, we have free shipping anywhere in the U.S. The accompanying eight DVD series here, and I've watched this, not every last moment of it because I just didn't have the time,
yeah,
but I've watched a lot. I've watched parts of every DVD in this set, and I want to tell you, he'll get your attention, and Billy has a way of doing that. The Final Countdown, Tribulation Rising, Volume 2, eight DVDs, yours for $50. The book and the DVD, yours for a gift of $75, free shipping anywhere in the United States, and you just go to prophecywatchers.tv, scroll down in the online library, and you'll find Billy's name, and you'll find this offer for the final countdown. And Billy, we have just a few seconds left. Talk to somebody out there who is just this close to receiving Christ, but hasn't quite done it yet.
Well, the Bible's very clear. God is holy. We are not. The wages of our sin is death. We are disqualified for heaven, myself included. But the good news is Jesus came. God sent his son, Jesus, to take the death penalty in our place. That the Bible says that if we confess him as Lord, believe in our heart that God raised him from the grave, we will be saved. Trust in Jesus to save you. There's no other way out of this mess other than him. And it's just a simple prayer way. Just call upon his name before it's too late.
Amen. And we will be praying for you and yours. That's our ministry here at Prophecy Watchers. And not only that, we're watching. You be watching too.